welcome, and don't worry, we'll play the rest of that incredible Telemann quartet at the end of the concert. That was just the overture. It's been a year, hasn't it? So thank you for clapping for us, but let's give you a hand for showing up. So thank you for coming. It's been a while since we played in front of a real audience. You probably know we made a bunch of videos during the pandemic, and that's how we kind of tried to keep busy. We also made bunches of videos for other groups as well. But it's wonderful to be back doing it for real. Our next piece, I think we chose partly because of the conditions that we've all lived under. This piece by Carl Philipp Emmanuel Bach, the trio Sanguineus and Melancholicus, it's not just a wonderful piece, it's a brilliant psychological portrait of an optimist and a pessimist. Now, in this case, I'm going to be the optimist, and Tatiana's going to be the pessimist, which is not necessarily the roles that we play in real life, but that's what we're going to be today. And I would say that the last year and a half has given plenty of chances for both of these types to go at each other, the optimists and the pessimists, right? So you'll see that in the first movement, we see things a different way. She thinks everything is terrible, and I'm trying to convince her that no, things are not. We briefly play the same type of music once in a while, but it's in a sort of combative way. In the second movement, we're still in that mode of she plays the depressing, woe is me music, and I try to cheer her up. But at the end of it, she briefly actually plays the happy music, just a little bit. And so it seems like we found agreement, and we have, because in the third movement, we really are on the same page, bickering like any married couple would.
Thank you.
Composer on this program that you probably have never heard of. That's because we know very little about him. But we know that in the 1730s he published a collection of wonderful cello music, and you're about to hear one of these sonatas.
Thank you. Thank you.
So I should probably tell you the story of this next piece, because there's at least one person in this audience that knows that this is not an oboe sonata. You know what happens when kids have a homework assignment and a parent helps because the parent is involved, and that's good. But you know how sometimes the parent just kind of takes over and does the entire homework for the kid? I imagine that probably happened a lot if your father was Johann Sebastian Bach. I mean, just imagine getting a homework assignment and dad is looking over your shoulder, ready to scratch out anything you do. This apparently happened with several pieces that have been attributed to the father, but were probably actually written by the son with a lot of over-the-shoulder corrections and rewritings and just like replotting the entire thing. I think this is probably what happened here. It is certainly not Bach through and through, but it is mostly Bach. So I think he did his kids' homework for him. Probably Carl Philipp Emmanuel was the younger of the two composers that had a hand in this. Of course, this was originally written for flute, and because some inconsistencies in the manuscript has been questioned, the authorship has been questioned, but I don't question it because I think it is exactly what it sounds like. Mostly dad in what started out to be an assignment for junior.
Thank you.
capable hands, for our harpsichord Philipp, who's going to play a piece that probably needs no introduction because it's from one of the greatest published collections of music ever. Thank you. When Telemann published his quartets that have been known since then as the Paris quartets, he was actually trying to make a name for himself in Paris, open up that big music market to his collections of published music. And so he was intentionally copying the French style, which of course he was very familiar with, but this time it had to be kind of right, because he was going to have them published there. And ironically, what happened is that, yes, he did get a lot of the true French there and there, but he also came up with some of the most quintessentially Telemann pieces ever, and trying to copy a style that was kind of foreign, part of his true self came out. I think this collection is just about as good as Telemann gets, which is very, very good indeed. Several movements, we played the overture already, and now we're going to go back and forth between E minor and E major in the manner of a French suite.
Thank you. come on.